The pictures on his wall are from 50 years ago, but Ernest Green remembers it like yesterday.
Well, I think what stands out is the fact that I, as a teenager, thought that desegregating the schools in Little Rock was an important part of progress for African Americans.
Green was one of the Little Rock Nine, a group of African American students who enrolled in Central High School in the Arkansas Capitol in 1957. While Green was making history in the schools, his family navigated the segregated roads using a little-known guide for African-American families.
The Green Book was a, I think, an institution in black life. It was one of those unknown survival tools for black people that had to move around the country. I was a teenager, so I knew that the Green Book was a necessity for us to have a place to stay.
A place to stay, a place to eat, even a car repair shop that would be friendly to blacks, all pulled together in this directory. Decades later, Green had forgotten about the precious resource until a recent conversation with Calvin Ramsey, a playwright and author.
He mentioned that he was doing a play around this book. And as he described it, I remember that I had had a personal experience with the Green Book. My aunt and mother mapping out a program for us to travel from Little Rock to Hampton, Virginia for my sister's graduation.
Personal tales like this inspired the playwright, and he learned about the travel guide's 1936 genesis.
Well, Victor Green, African-American gentleman who has traveled himself, and had hardships on the road, embarrassing situations that he didn't want to see his people continue to have. So he said, if I can do something about this, I will.
The idea took off, and year after year, the Green Book grew, providing resources for all 50 states.
Everything from lodging to restaurants to beauty shops to barber shops, mechanic shops, later on doctor's offices, dentists, pretty much anything you would need on the open road.
As the book gained popularity, it also picked up a major sponsor.
Once Standard Oil got involved, they hired professional marketeers. They set up an office in New York. They hired men who had training in this type of thing. Then they started training African-American men how to run their own service stations. And from there, they could sell more Green Books.
Today, Ramsey takes his children's book, Ruth and the Green Book, to elementary schools, bringing old tales to a new audience, and in the process, picking up on a dream that the creator of the Green Book held dearly.
Travel, exposure, knowledge, all of it is fatal to prejudice. It requires people to think broader to this idea about universality that begin to see people as people.
Big lessons from the little guide that history almost forgot. Fredricka Whitfield, CNN, Atlanta.